गुड डे चिल्ड्रेन, साई राम एंड वेलकम बैक टू आवर सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी एंड सेकेंड लेसन वी आर स्टार्टिंग ओवर हियर, दैट इज़ द एंडोजेनेटिक मूवमेंट. चिल्ड्रेन, व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ एंडोजेनेटिक मूवमेंट? द मूवमेंट दैट टेक्स प्लेस इनसाइड द अर्थ्स क्रस्ट, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एंडोजेनेटिक मूवमेंट. सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद द एंडोजेनेटिक मूवमेंट, आई विल शो यू वन न्यूज़पेपर स्निपेट. In this newspaper snippet, one article is given to you regarding Nepal devastated. You will have to read this article and answer some of my question. I'll read it for you. Nepal devastated. Powerful earthquake rocks Nepal, nearly 1500 killed. Kathmandu, 25th April. A powerful earthquake measuring 7.9 on Richter scale struck Nepal today. Nearly 1500 people were killed and over 1000 people were injured in the disaster. The quake and a series of serious aftershocks delivered a severe blow to Nepal. The tremors were also felt across vast stretches of East and Northeast India. It was also felt in China, Bhutan and as far as Pakistan and Bangladesh. The earthquake with epicenter at Lamjung, around 80 kilometers northwest of Kathmandu, had its impact in several cities in Bihar, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh. The initial report said the tremor measured 7.9 magnitude. It said the quake hit at 11:40 a.m. local time at a shallow depth of 11 kilometers. There were 17 major aftershocks measuring over 5 in the next 2.5 hours, said an officer of the National Seismological Center. Another aftershock measuring 6.6 hit 80 minutes after the quake. This is the largest earthquake in Nepal after 80 years. India has sent rescue teams immediately. So children, we have read the newspaper snippet. Now answer some of my questions. What caused the large scale casualties? As you can see in the newspaper article over here, what was the main cause over here? It was the powerful earthquake. What was the magnitude of the earthquake? Can you see where the magnitude is? Yes, it is 7.9 Richter scale. Which country was the most affected by this earthquake? You can see in the newspaper over here, it is Nepal was the country. Where was the epicenter of the earthquake? Can you see where the epicenter is? Yes, it is at Lamjung. Which are the other affected areas? If we talk about India, in India, Bihar, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh were affected. While if you talk about outside India, it was China, Bhutan, Pakistan and Bangladesh also. At what depth was the focus located? At what depth was the focus located? At the depth of 11 kilometers. What kind of damage is seen because of the earthquake? See in the article what damage was caused? Yes, nearly 1500 people were killed and over 1000 people were injured in the disaster. According to you, what could be the reason behind the earthquake? Can you tell me what could be the reason behind the earthquake? Correct, it is the tremors or the movement inside the earth's crust. So let's continue with our lesson. Like this disaster, there are many other disasters also taking place on the surface of the earth, like the snowfall, then the storms, then the floods. These are the various other disasters taking place on the earth's surface which causes harm to the human beings as well as animals. Apart from these disasters, even earthquakes and volcanoes are also disasters. These are more disastrous, we can say. When this occur, there is a lot of loss of life and property. So we call it as natural calamities. So today in this lesson, we are going to learn about these natural calamities which take place because of the movement inside the earth's crust, which is also called as endogenetic movements. So let's start with it. Before starting, let me show you one experiment.
Here are some books arranged, and on that books we can see some things kept, like the duster and the two other things. Now, if we are just removing one book from that hip, you will find that what happens is all the things on the books fell down. While if you see in the next case, now again the things, again the books and the things are arranged properly. Now here I am not going to remove any of the books. I am just going to give a little bit push to the books. See what is happening? The things are just shaking or moving. Now I will give a hard push to the things. So what will happen? All the things will fall down.
Let's have a geographical explanation of what we have seen in the video now. Earthquakes and volcanoes occur because of the instability in the interior of the earth. As I have told you first only, what is endogenetic movement? So why do earthquakes and volcanoes take place? Because of the instability that takes place inside the earth's crust. The movement in the earth's interior occur in the upper layer of the mantle. Children, you all must have learned in your 8th standard about the different layers of the earth's crust. That is the crust, then the mantle and the core. And you all know the mantle is divided into upper mantle and lower mantle. Okay, so here where is the movement taking place? In the upper layer of the mantle. So what happens in the upper, because of this movement in the upper layer of the mantle? Tremendous energy is released by radioactive materials in the mantle. Okay, a lot and lot of energy is released out, which travel from one place to another, causing instability. Okay, as we have seen in the experiment just now, when I pushed the books, okay, because of the instability, what happened? All the things over it started falling down. So this is the geographical explanation. The movements are classified on the basis of their velocity, their direction and the landforms. So here is the classification of internal movements. Well, according to velocity, slow movements are there and sudden movements are there. According to direction, if you talk, horizontal direction, upward direction and downward direction movement. These are the movements I am talking about. Then if you talk about the landforms, here continental building is done. Continent building is done, that is creating continents, plateaus, highlands. Okay, that is continent building. And what is mountain building? Mountain building means folding, faulting. This is called as mountain building. So classification of internal movements, everybody has understood. Movements is classified on the basis of velocity, direction and landforms. On the basis of velocity, that is slow movements, okay, which occur continuously. And what is sudden movements? Which occur in the form of events, that is called as sudden movements. So everybody has understood. And what about landforms? Landforms like continent building, mountain building. And direction, in which direction? Horizontal direction, horizontal movement, upward movement, downward movement. This is the classification of internal movements inside the earth's crust. Let's see one small experiment about the slow movements.
Take a 30 cm long paper strip. Place your hands on both the ends of the strip. Now, move both the hands towards each other, giving pressure on the strip. Observe what happens to the...
Now, seeing this experiment, let's have a geographical explanation of what we have seen in the experiment. In the experiment, what did we see? We have applied force from both the sides over the strip of paper. That means a compression was developed because of the pressure which was applied by both the hands. Okay, in the same way here we are going to have a geographical explanation why the fold mountains and the block mountains are formed. This is the slow movement. Let's talk about the fold mountains first. Because of the energy waves and pressure working towards each other and in horizontal direction, the layers of soft rocks form folds. Just now we have seen in the experiment the strip of paper. When it is applied force, pressure working towards each other, then what happens? A compression was developed. Okay, same way the soft rocks form folds over here. If the pressure is too high, as we have seen on the paper itself, when the pressure was too high, then the folds are too large. It becomes too large and their complexity also increases. Okay, when we are applying too much of pressure, the folds are becoming too larger and the complexity of that also increases. Same way, the surface of the earth gets uplifted and fold mountains are formed. Same way with the earth's surface. And pressure is applied from both the sides towards each other, mountains are formed. Now you all must be knowing the Himalayan mountain of India. This is the result of this fold mountain. The Himalayas, the Aravallis, the Rockies, the Andes, the Alps, all these are examples of fold mountains. Let's move on to the next slow movement. Before that, just see over here, a pressure is given from both the side. You can see the fault over here, because of which a block has come up. So here we are going to talk about is the block mountains. Now what are block mountains? When the pressure becomes too much, internally horizontal waves moving away from each other. Here we are talking about is away from each other. Before we start with the block mountain, here is an experiment to show what happens because of the pressure applied away from each other.
Take a long stick of thin paper. Hold one end of the paper in your right hand. Hold the other in your left hand. Pull both the ends away from each other. Observe what happens to the paper strip.
Let's have a geographical explanation of what we have seen in the video just now. Okay, here you can see in this diagram over here that when pressure is working in the opposite direction, a block is coming up. That is called as a block mountain. Let's have a geographical explanation over here to know how a block mountain is formed. When internally horizontal waves moving away from each other cause tension on the layer of rocks. Okay, it is causing a tension on the layer of rocks which leads to fractures in the rock known as faults. Just now we have seen in the diagram over here, fractures are formed in the rocks. Okay. As well as waves coming towards each other in hard rocks also form faults due to compression. Compression part we have seen in the previous experiment what I have shown you. That is the compression. Part of the earth's crust in between two faults is lifted to look like a block known as block mountain. Okay, so here when a compression also takes place, a block mountain is formed, or when a tension is created, a fracture is created, then also a block mountain is formed. Now what is the characteristic of the block mountain? When a block mountain is formed, the hilltops are flat. The hilltops are flat. That means the peak part, the topmost point of the mountain is flat. In the early stage, they have no peaks. What are peaks? Just now I told you, the pointed part is called as peaks. Then, here in this mountain, the slopes are steep, very, very steep. Okay, examples of block mountains over here is Black Forest, Black Forest Mountains, the Meghalaya Plateau. All these are the examples of block mountains. You can see over here the picture showing Meghalaya Plateau, which is also a block mountain. As we have seen in the earlier experiment, that when horizontal movements on the earth's surface act in opposite direction, it causes tension, okay, on the rocks and the earth's crust. Okay, so what happens actually? It causes a tension on the earth's crust. When tension is increasing, fractures develop in the rocks. You can see in this picture over here, fractures are developed in the rock. This leads to the formation of faults. Okay, and between two faults, the subsided land which is there, that is called as a valley. So here it is the rift valley we are going to talk about. When two fractures develop side by side, just now we have seen in the diagram, in the earth's crust, the land in between the two fractures subsides, called as rift valley. That only I told you just now. When there are two fractures in the same rock, the two fractures go side by side, while the middle portion goes down, that is subsides. Now, what is the characteristic of the rift valley? The rift valley slopes are very much steep. You have an example over here, the rift valley of river Narmada, the great rift valley of Africa, the Rhine river rift valley of Europe. These are the various rift valleys we can find on the earth's surface. Till now we have seen about mountain building. Now let's talk about continental building, that is epiorogenic. Slow movement occurs towards the center or from center towards crust. So here we are learning about slow movement till now. So when the slow movement is occurring towards the center or center towards the crust, this is the slow movement. Because of this, a part of the earth's crust is uplifted or get subsided. Just now we have seen about the compression and the tension cause, then the rift valley we have seen. So this is all a part of the continent building. A part of the earth's crust is uplifted or gets subsided. When the earth's crust is uplifted, continents are formed. Or extensive plateaus can also be formed. Okay, just because of the compression and the tension, what happens? Either a continent can be formed or a extensive plateau also can be formed. If the continental portion of the crust subsides below the sea level, it forms a part of the sea bed. Suppose the part of the land or the part of the crust goes inside the sea level, then it becomes a part of the seabed. It does not remain a continent at all. When it is above sea level, it is a continent. But when it goes inside the sea, under the sea level, it becomes a part of the seabed. So this is called as continent building. So till now we have learned about is the slow movement. The nextly we are going to learn is about the sudden movement. The movement that takes place very much sudden, that is called as sudden movement. Here we are talking about is the sudden movements. Now, what are sudden movements? In the beginning of the lesson only we have learned that we have studied the news item of earthquake. Your earth means the ground and the quake means the trembling of the ground. So, earthquake is the movement of the earth's crust. You have been acquainted with the magnitude and effects of the earthquake in the starting of the lesson. So you all know what is an earthquake. So let's start. What is sudden movement? Earthquake and volcanoes are types of sudden movements. We have learned at the starting of the lesson. Earth means the ground and quake means trembling. We have seen the magnitude and the effects of the earthquake in the starting of the lesson. So now we are going in the next lecture, we'll learn about the sudden movements, that is the earthquakes. Thank you, children.